a situation on the St. Louis bench, and the emergency medics on the ice, the stretcher brought out, both teams collecting themselves at center ice. It was a wild scene on the St. Louis bench as players lifted the bench out of the way in an attempt to make room.
John, he just collapsed, and we're uncertain as to which player it was at this point.
Well, at this point in time, it does none of us any good to speculate as to what happened or even to whom they are attending to right now, but it was a wild scene. The St. Louis players literally lifting the bench up and just moving it away to allow the medical personnel to quickly get there. And this clearly is going to affect whether or not this hockey game continues.
John, they initially signaled for Anaheim's trainer that there was a problem on the bench, and immediately he sent a signal to the two team doctors who are positioned immediately behind the Ducks bench, and they were on the scene within about 30 seconds, I would say.
Well, the stretcher has been taken back across the ice surface to the Zamboni entrance. The emergency medical personnel remain at the end of the St. Louis bench, and they continue to work. At this point in time, we believe the player who is down to be Jay Bomister. And of course, the concern from both teams is palpable. As you can see, both clubs gathered at center ice and trying to give as much room as possible, but obviously there's a great deal of concern. Players coming over to the area between the benches, trying to get as much information as they can from both my broadcast colleague Brian Hayward and St. Louis Blues television color analyst Darren Pang, who was down there with him in that position between the benches. It was certainly chaotic. Both teams are heading off to the locker rooms right now, and we'll await word from the officials as to whether or not this game will continue, and if so, what course of action it will continue in.
Well, the referees right now are on the headsets talking to the situation room in Toronto. I think they're looking for some direction. The players on the ice that I've spoken with at this point are unsure what's going to happen at this point.
Ryan Getzlaf, the Ducks captain, in a conversation with one of the linesmen over there. Ryan O'Reilly is there as well for the Blues. And they will break that up and head off to the respective locker rooms now, and we'll await word. Certainly, unfortunately, we've seen situations like this before in the league. Yuri Fisher collapsed years ago in Detroit.
And, John, you can see Alex Steen and Ryan Getzlaf talking to the officials right now. Well, Getzlaf was having a conversation with the captains of the St. Louis Blues before he went to see the officials.
And the officials have left the ice surface as well as the remaining players that were on the ice.
So of paramount importance here is the health of Jay Bomister, first and foremost. The referees have gone into the Blues locker room, and I'm sure they're going to inquire about the condition of Bomister, but they're also going to talk to the St. Louis Blues, I would imagine, about whether or not they would want to continue in this game.
And you can see the medical personnel in the stretcher, and we have no idea who it is, if it's a player, if it's a security person. I mean, we're not going to speculate at all. I have no idea, but this is obviously a very, very serious situation.
Medical personnel from the Anaheim Ducks made their way down from the stands, the trainers there. It's certainly one of the Blues players. These are just moments you don't prepare for. And
again, this happened during our TV timeout, and we have no idea who it is. And so, Darren, we saw the player taken off on the stretcher, and times like this, you just say a prayer. And here is the last sequence before the break, Darren.
Yes.
And this is all we saw.
Well, obviously, you see at that point the veteran defenseman going down, and everybody on the bench absolutely just startled, absolutely calling the trainers. Ray Burilli was to my left, and you could see the urgency of the matter and the look in the players' faces. And Ryan Getzlaff in front of me is with talking with Colton Parayko and Ryan O'Reilly.
So, Darren, it did appear it was Bouwmeester who went down there, and the players are all going to the locker room. And the second we get any information, we will certainly pass it along. Just a very, very scary situation here at Honda Center in Anaheim. But, Darren, as we know, there are doctors at every game, medical personnel, emergency personnel, and he will get the very best care possible. And we just say a prayer at this point.